Oh, time now, 6:15. We all have our cold weather stories. If you've lived up north for a short time, I lived in North Carolina, which is not, you know, up north. Yeah, and I don't have any of the winter clothes anymore. So
Oh, you never get rid of those winter clothes. I got like one or two things. No, every season I add to my winter collection. I do.
Well, you're a fashionista. You always look fantastic.
Well, thank you. No, my husband's like, what do you need all those sweaters and scarves for? I'm like, someday I will. And today is that day, folks, because I'll tell you, it is cold out there. We're waking up to temperatures this morning in the 30s, but you factor in the wind chill, feels more like the upper 20s. So make sure you bundle up as you head outside. Keep in mind, we have a freeze warning in effect until about 9 o'clock this morning. Farmers are keeping close watch on their tender vegetation and crops. They'll also be keeping watch tonight, too, as temperatures are expected to dip below freezing once again. A wind chill advisory also in effect this morning. As I mentioned, the air feels a lot colder than what that temperature reads this morning. We've already set a new record for today in Vero Beach. You're waking up to 32 degrees right now. That breaks the old record of 38 degrees for this day set back in 1977. Currently 39 degrees in West Palm Beach. The record is 36. We may come awfully close to tying that record that was set back in 1937. Temperatures will continue to drop over the next several hours. Right now, here's a look at where we are this morning. Vero, you're waking up to 31. It's 27 degrees in Port St. Lucie, 38 in West Palm, and 40 degrees in Boca Raton. Those were the temps. Now look at the wind chills. Feels more like 26 degrees in Vero Beach. In Port St. Lucie, 27. This is why I say bundle up, throw on the scarf if you need to this morning, or even the gloves. 31 degrees is the what it feel like temperature out there right now in West Palm Beach. The satellite and radar composite, nice and dry, seeing a few high clouds across the area, but mostly sunny skies, and that's a good thing because we're going to need all that sunshine to warm us up as cold air continues to push down the state. It's going to be another cold night tonight, too, with temperatures very similar to what we're seeing this morning. We're going to see it again tomorrow morning as well, and we're not the only ones. Take a look to our north. They're dealing with these frigid temperatures as well, all part of that same cold system that moved across the area over the last 24 hours, but it's bringing snow across the Midwest, places like Detroit, Ohio, into Buffalo, New York, dealing with a lot of snow out there today again. Sunny skies for us, chilly temperatures, though. We're going to warm up, but not by much. Highs only reaching the 50s today. Yeah, we're going to struggle to make it out of the 50s. Tonight, clear and cold once again. That freeze warning in effect as temperatures are expected to dip at or below freezing for several hours tomorrow morning. Clear skies by tomorrow afternoon, though, and breezy. Temperatures just a little bit warmer. We'll actually make it into the mid-60s by Wednesday. Small craft advisory remains in effect for boaters with seas running 3 to 5 feet. Inland waters a moderate chop. Winds out of the northwest at about 15 to 20 knots. We'll leave you now with a look at your five-day forecast. It gets better. If you're not a fan of this cold weather here in South Florida, by Friday, we're going to turn up the heat. Temperatures climbing back into the mid-70s. More seasonal temps for this time of year, but you have to wait a couple of more days.